Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to study the De Morgan's theorem. There are two De Morgan's theorem that we are going to see in this tutorial. This question was asked in mini examination for 5 to 10 marks. A question may be asked like, state and prove the De Morgan's theorem. De Morgan's theorems are basically used to simplify the expressions, digital expressions. De Morgan formulated two theorems for the simplification of expressions. The first theorem, De Morgan first theorem, stated that the complement of some term is equal to the product of individual complements, and it is represented by this example: a plus b, the whole complement, is equals to a complement into b complement. The De Morgan's second theorem said that the complement of the product term, the complement of the product term, is equal to the sum of complement of individual variables, and it is represented by the expression like this. It's a product term, a into b, the whole complement, is equals to a complement plus b complement. If you see here, the sign is replaced from left hand side to right hand side in this theorems, right? So the sum term becomes the product term. Here the product term becomes the sum term. We'll see now the proof of the both the theorems of De Morgan's. To prove this theorems, we're going to prepare a table where we are going to create a column for each and every term given into this theorem. Okay, so I'll prepare a table here where our first column is variable a, second is variable b, next we need a complement, so third column I have prepared as a complement, next we need b complement also in the theorems, next I need a plus b, which was given in the theorems. This is the term required. Then I also need a product term ab. I want to find the complement of this term, that is a plus b whole complement. Then we'll find the complement of the product term also. After that, we'll multiply these two columns, a complement into b complement. And the last term that is needed to satisfy the theorem is a complement plus b complement. So all the terms that were needed in the satisfaction of the theorem are given here now. These are two inputs variables. A and b are two inputs. For two input variables, we have possible combinations like 0, 0, then 0, 1, 1, 0. And then 1 1. How to find a complement? A complement can be found by replacing 0 by 1 and 1 by 0 here in this column. So the 0 will be replaced by 1, this will be replaced by 1, this 1 will be replaced by 0, this 1 will be replaced by 0. Now to find b complement, we'll replace this 0 by 1 and this 1 by 0. So this becomes 1 0 1 0. Now to find a plus b, we have to add these two inputs, a plus b. When you do that, 0 plus 0 is 0 in truth table, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, and 1 plus 1 is 1 in truth tables. Now find the product of two input signals a and b, multiply these two, so you get 0, 0, 0 into 1 is 0, 1 into 0 is 0, 1 into 1 is 1. How to find this term now? A plus b, the whole complement. We already found this a plus b term, right? Take the complement of this column, you'll get a plus b whole complement. How to get the complement of this? Just replace the 0 by 1, 1 by 0. So this becomes 1, 0, 0, 0. Find the complement of the product term. So we already found a into b. Take the complement of this column, you'll get 1, 1, 1, 0 here. Then we have to find the product of a complement into b complement. It means we have to multiply these two columns. Multiply this. 1 into 1 is 1. 1 into 0 is 0. 0 into 1 is 0. 0 into 0 is 0. The last column we are going to find is a complement plus b complement. So we have two inputs, a complement and b complement. We have to add these two columns. So when you perform a 1 plus 1, the answer is 1. Then next is 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. So we have prepared the full table to satisfy both the theorems of De Morgan's. I'll just put the column numbers here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I am going to utilize this table to prove the first theorem of De Morgan as well as second theorem of De Morgan's. To prove the first theorem of De Morgan's, that is a plus b, the whole complement, is equals to a complement into b complements, right? It means that from column number 7 and column number 9, from column number 7 and from column number 9, we can say that the first theorem of De Morgan's is proved. From column number 7 and column number 9, first theorem is proved. That is, a plus b, the whole complement, that is a plus b, the whole complement, equals to a complement into b complement. So we used column number 7 and column number 9. The outputs are same into these columns. Both the columns are matching. That's why a plus b, the whole complement, equals to a complement into b complement. Now, from column number 8 and column number 10. From column number 8 and column number 10, if you see this, the values are same in both the columns, right? So the second theorem is proved from column number 8 and column number 9. And from column number 7 and column number 9, the first theorem is proved. Therefore, from column 8 and 10, the second theorem is proved. That is, a into b, the whole complement, it's a product term, a into b, the whole complement, equals to a complement plus b complement, right? So this way we can prove the De Morgan's theorem. So in this tutorial we have studied what is De Morgan's theorem and how to prove both the theorems of De Morgan's. For that we use a truth table method to prove both the theorems.